Kendall, somebody that was recruited when Butch was coming in and has played his entire career, you've gotten to see Tennessee kind of the before and where it's been left. How do you think that the Butch Jones era should be remembered, and from where the program was to now, how would you explain that to people who maybe don't understand where it was when you were a recruit to where you're leaving as a senior?
Yeah, we've had some pretty good years here under his tenure. Past three seasons, we won bowl games. Started in Jacksonville, then went to the Alphabet Bowl, and then ended up in Nashville. So the past 3 years, we've been in bowl games. We won bowl games. Not too many Tennessee teams have won that. He's accomplished that. So he had left it in a better place when I got here. So.
I know you won't be around for it, but there's a coaching search going on. What do you want to see from the next coach? What qualities does the next coach need to have in order to get Tennessee back to where y'all want it to be?
Whoever's the next coach is going to be is going to do a great job with just everything that the job has to come for. If they're a great person or they're a great coach, they can recruit. I'm sure they're going to do a great job. And we have a lot here that can help them, bring Tennessee back to where it needs to be.
In the end, why didn't it work? What happened this year to get it to this point?
We had some games that we could have won that didn't necessarily go in our direction. One, two plays could change the outcome of the season. And unfortunately, it didn't go the way we wanted it to go. But ultimately, we just got to keep pushing forward and just got to play these next two games, get three.
What are you expecting out of Coach Hoak, and just what's he been like the last couple of days since he's been the interim coach?
I know the D-line has a good feel on how Coach Hoak is going to approach things. He brings a lot of energy to the table. He's going to push you. He'll let you know when you're doing good. He'll let you know when you're messing up. So that's a great quality he has. He's a great motivator. He's a great person. And I know he's going to get everybody's 100% game when the time comes.
How frustrating was it against Missouri to not be able to stop the run? And then talk a little bit about the challenge of stopping LSU and Darius Geis.
Yeah, it was very frustrating. Even watch the film, there's a lot of stuff that we can control. And the fact that we weren't able to do that is frustrating, but we got to move forward. LSU creates a bunch of problems too. They have a great O-line. They have two running backs that do a lot. They got one of the best running backs in the nation. So it's going to create he creates a bunch of problems. But we got to have a good preparation this week. Getting ready for the game, and I think we'll be okay.
Against Missouri, was it missed tackles and missed fits? Was that the primary thing?
Yeah, a lot of it was a tackling aspect of it. I don't think we tackled as well as we have this year. I don't think our defense, our effort was as good as it's been this year either. Like I said, we got this week to look forward and move on, and we can get better from it.
What would you say to Alabama, the LSU fan that says they're coming in here, they've won the last four or five, they lost Alabama just by 14 points, they're 7-3, while Tennessee just lost its head coach, hasn't won an SEC game yet. How do you counter that with the momentum they're bringing in?
You got to come in and play. It's as simple as that. We're going to be ready to play on Saturday. We had a team meeting, and guys were like, if you don't want to be here, don't be here. And everybody stayed, so everybody wants to put in the work. Everybody wants to be able to get these last two wins, and now we're playing for wins. So.
Kendall, after the Florida fired its coach, their next game, they didn't play worth a flip. Is there a concern that could happen in Tennessee, that the players may not be as invested like Florida wasn't against Missouri?
I don't know. I don't like comparing that, but we'll be ready to play.
Like the mentality of you got two games left, you got to get to a bowl game, let's pull out all the stops, whether it's blitzes, whether it's trick plays on offense, or do you just like to see what Tennessee's been doing, all the season?
We'll leave it up to the coaches to create a game plan and leave it up to the players to execute that game plan. pay a lot of money to do what they do, and we trust them.
You think Coach going to spice it up?
I don't know. We'll have to find out.
Thanks, Kyle.